An old curmudgeon lives on a piece of secluded swampland. He's hated by the people in town because they're irrationally afraid of him. Due to some questionable zoning regulations, squatters begin to move onto the swampland after being kicked out of their homes. Angered by this, the crotchety main character visits the local government office to file a complaint. There, he's told that if he can go retrieve something for the town, the zoning laws will be rewritten and the squatters will be told to leave.
Wait, that's not how any of that works.
Is the donkey his lawyer in this situation?
The movie is Shrek. James nailed it.
I never saw Shrek.
You never have seen the movie Shrek?
What?
There's a bunch of fairy tale creatures that end up getting like thrown out of the kingdom and have to like live on his property, and he's like all upset about it.
Do they have to live on his property?
Yeah, they have nowhere else to go. They were pushed into the swamp by the policies of Farquaad.
Exactly. And so Shrek, as a disgruntled, you know, citizen, marches up to the kingdom and is like, "Hey, Farquaad, this is ridiculous." And Farquaad's like, "Hey, if you go and rescue Princess Fiona, who is a princess that lives in a tower, you get to
evict these people from your land."
Exactly.
You might establish a tenancy.
It's harder than you think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You have to establish tenancy, and you may be able to hold over, which is usually like how most.
And it takes like 20 years, 21 years.
So let's say a property does belong to Shrek.
Yeah. Because I think it's more interesting if that is the case.
He should just be able to eject them. He technically has a legal right to have the police come and he should use the state, but theoretically, let it happen in like a real U.S. state, where someone just came onto your property and set up a tent.
Yeah.
You can eject them generally from the property.
Let's assume Shrek passes.
God, that sounds terrible.
Let's assume Shrek passes.
Yeah. They would do an heir search. They would try to find the heirs. And then they would do publication.
Yeah. Who's they?
The court.
The court. Yeah.
It's someone filed to get possession of the swamp and realize, let's presume he had a deed to the swamp registered it somehow. They would do it. Someone would be like, "Who owns that swamp?" And they'd find out that this dead guy, whatever, owns it, Shrek. Gotcha. And then they'd do an heir search and then probably find his nearest relative.
So before that heir search happened, somebody would have to like want to buy the land
Either they want to buy the land or the government want their property taxes.
Often it's like late taxes are going to be like a triggering event for the government to look into it.
Gotcha.
Yeah, but the government then has a tax sale and forecloses on it, then the government needs to know what to do with the money.
Gotcha.
And also it now owns a property. But I'll suggest Shrek have a will. Even if Shrek was like, "I want it to go to anyone but my family."
Yeah.
You could theoretically have a will that has a sole purpose of disinheriting people, but then it would still go to your heirs who you haven't disinherited.
But I will say this, you know, so say his family's all gone. He has no family. He has no friends. There's nobody. There's nothing. And he has some stuff. Eventually, that would revert to the state.
Eventually.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've never seen it happen because they've always been able to find somebody, even like your eighth cousin, whatever, twice removed. Mm-hmm. But you could conceivably see a scenario where the state either takes it or the state buys it more or less and holds the funds for someone to come out of the woodwork.
Right.
Later in the movie, Shrek meets Donkey, who becomes his like best friend by default. Like, it's his only
friend.
You have
your one friend.
The only person who can stand Shrek.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so they obviously don't have a legal relationship as best friends. So if
I can't believe, of course, I haven't recognized that yet.
My BFF.
When are we going to legalize ogre donkey marriage?
or friendship. We should have friendship in the We can leave like by deed, by will, or by trust.
Okay.
But you would have to do something.
Yeah.
For your property to go to a friend, for a member, like someone who's not just a member of your family, you have to document that.
Gotcha. Yeah. Later in the film, Shrek gets married. Assuming he created the will when he was friends with Donkey, would he have to create a new will now that he's married?
Yes. So a will – so if a will is not written in anticipation of that particular marriage, it doesn't apply to that spouse. So I would want to redo the will. A trust or a deed, less so, but I would still want to reevaluate that. Again, that's kind of looking at the whole thing.
Okay. I think the main moral of the story is that, Steven, you need to watch Shrek.
Obviously.
Like that's
at least
crazy.
Shrek 1 and 2.
Guys, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, let us know. Post a comment. Guys, we went to the trouble of creating you a fantastic PDF listed in the description of this video. It is a summary of the key mistakes to avoid when planning for your estate. You can go get that. Steven and James both wrote it together, and it is a summary of all of the mistakes they've seen people make as they think about estate planning. Don't make those mistakes. Your family is the ones that's going to pay for it, and they're not going to like you very much. So that's how you go and avoid them. Click the link in the description. You can get that PDF. It's absolutely free. You're welcome.